It's the music release people have been hanging out for. For the first time in 12 years, Kev Carmody has a new CD, or should I say four new CDs of material written and collected over decades, but never recorded until now. Recollections, Reflections, A Journey was recorded in a studio set up in a giant former fruit packing shed, and the sound is wonderful and unique. Kev Carmody came into Living Black Radio last week and spoke to Michelle Lovegrove.
I've walked on this earth through the wet and the dry. I've endured in the deserts and the snows.
It's four CD albums in the old sense. I mean, there's four of them. There's over 40 songs, and they sort of people with family and that have been on to me for ages, like all those songs that you've got in those folders. Like Paul Kelly's a big one at it.
Yeah.
Oh, Kev, you know, those old songs that you got in there, you should record them. So they date back to 1967, but also right up to date, to 2014. And it's the way they were recorded that's, I feel, pretty flaming unique, because it's we recorded all our own sounds, especially the natural sounds.
I've been admired and defiled as a temptress and a saint. I've endured under every male law. And that earth mother's woman child. Child of the earth.
We recorded in Andy's old former big fruit packing shed, and he put a little studio in there, and it was part of a huge big shed that was full of old junk and, you know, 200 litre steel drums and stuff, and we just hit on those sort of things, tyre rims, bicycle pumps, chains.
Oh my goodness.
And we put the recorder out on the fence post at 5 o'clock in the morning and recorded all the birds. I recorded my tractor, you know, playing a handsaw, a butter knife. I got the grandkids, you know, whistles and stuff that they have as children, and played them.
To the tune, sustained by the fruits from the earth. I'm the Alpha Omega, the beginning and end. I'm the one that ensures constant rebirth.
I said to Andy, he's a drummer himself. I said, look, no drum kit, no bass guitar. Let's start off with that premise. It's going to be funny what people sort of like this, because it's over the 40-odd flaming tracks. It runs from a real old country, almost what we used to call in the 50s hillbilly music, you know, which turned into country and western, right through to this sort of, well, it's esoteric sort of flaming, surreal, I don't know what you'd call it, type music. But there's a hell of a spread. But the basis that I wanted to keep there was basically acoustic. Keep the sounds acoustic. We did cheat a little bit. But the next one I do, I might do totally electronic. I might do a John Cage. I don't know.
Do a Brian Eno. And
Yeah. Philip Glass.
Yeah, all of that.
But I thought I'd at least get this one out the road and then maybe have a go at another one. If we ever get the money.